Hi students, today I am going to discuss about second fundamental theorem of integral calculus. So here students, first of all we seek to know what is the statement of second fundamental theorem of integral calculus. So here students, let f be the let f be a continuous function defined on the closed interval the closed interval AB and capital F be an antiderivative antiderivative of f, then integration from a to b fx dx equal to capital fx from a to b, and the students, the value of this will be h equal to fb minus fa. Here students, the statements of this theorem is, if f be a continuous function defined on closed interval ab and f be an antiderivative of f, antiderivative means the capital f with the integral of the function f, so here will be integration from a to b fx dx equal to capital Fx from a to b, the value of this will be the function value at upper limit b minus the function value at lower limit a. Here students, this theorem is very useful for calculating definite integral without using as the limit of a sum. So it is very important theorem for solving definite integral. Okay, so now students, let solve an example. So here our example is integration from 2 to 3 x square dx. Now here students, we have to solve this definite integral by the help of fundamental theorem. So here students, by the result of this fundamental theorem, first of all we have to find the antiderivative of x square. Okay, here students, since antiderivative of x square dx is equal to x cube upon 3. Now using these results students, we can write it, therefore integration from 2 to 3 x square dx, here will be here the capital X is the antiderivative of fx, here x the antiderivative of x square is equal to x cube upon 3, so here will be x cube upon 3 from 2 to 3, okay, is equal to, here will be students, now using this result here will be 3 cube upon 3 minus 2 cube upon 3 is equal to 27 upon 3 minus 8 upon 3 equal to the LCM of this 3 and this 3 will be 3. Here will be 27 minus 8. Okay. Is equal to 19 upon 3. Okay. Which is the required value of this definite integral. So, here students, we can easily find definite integral by the help of this fundamental theorem without using as the limit of a sum. So, students, watch this theorem carefully and seek to understand how to use this theorem in definite integral. Thank you. Thank you so much.